In this video, I'll be going over how I did this step-by-step 36x18x36 do-it-yourself paludarium. It includes two waterfalls with two different pumps, 16 gallons of water, and how I separated the water from the land, a fogger, misting system, internal air ducts with 40mm fans, custom lid, two water overflow drains, feeding station, back chamber, exterior water heater, dry lock, and more. My goal is to show you the whole process on how this was built. I'll try to link as much stuff as possible in the description below. To start, my wife got me this awesome ExoTerra for Christmas. I took off the doors so they wouldn't snap off. Then I wiped down the enclosure with distilled water, then a little bit of rubbing alcohol. Next, I got a large sheet of corrugated plastic so I can create a back chamber, and I can hide all my plumbing for my water pumps. I measured this 38 inches high by 11 inches wide so I can test fit it and then trim it down and make it flush to the rim of the enclosure. Once having it cut out, I just found the vertical center so I can go ahead and fold it in half. I then started marking where I wanted my hole to be for water to pass through. Then I just went ahead and cut it out with a utility knife. I should have put the silicone and the screen on the front side of the chamber. This way it would have been more secure and had more support from the Great Stuff foam that would be going over the front side to hold it in place. I'll show you that correction later on in the video. After I had the corrugated plastic flush with the top trim, I went ahead and siliconed it into place. Feel free to run your finger along to create a nice smooth seal. Next, I'm drawing in with a permanent marker to get a feel for where I want my next piece of corrugated plastic to go to separate the land from the water. I then cut another piece of corrugated plastic, siliconed it in, and used braces to hold it in its place. I waited 24 hours for the silicone to cure. I then did a water test for 72 hours to check for leaks. Using 40mm fans, we'll start building the internal air ducts. This is a clip from a different build that I did, explaining how it pulls the air in from the bottom and tees it off at the top. I'll link that video now. In the meantime, here's the air duct system working with the fog, creating air circulation. I went ahead and used another piece of corrugated plastic to create the vertical portion of the air duct. I measured one of the sides of the 40mm fan and multiplied that by 4. Connected my measurements. Cut off the excess. I measured 2 inches down from the bottom. Marked the pieces that I wanted to cut off. Then folded over on all 3 lines. This tab here will create the bottom of the air duct. With everything folded over, go ahead and make a rectangle. This is the top of the vertical piece that I'm getting ready to cut so we can put our T in. I measured 2 inches down for this part as well. And then I cut to the line that I just created. This will allow us to put our horizontal piece right into that fitting. Now we're going to mark our hole that's going to pull the air up through the air duct itself. And then just cut out the hole. This is how the bottom portion of the first piece of the air duct should look once complete. It would have been easier and quicker if I used hot glue instead of silicone for this part. I did use some tape so I can hold the structure together, and use a clamp so I can go ahead and silicone the bottom tab to the base. I had to go ahead and cut off the screen because I accidentally added it first before adding silicone and cocoa fiber to hide the white background. It's important to know that mistakes will be made. You just go ahead and correct them when you need to. So this is a step I should have done after I filled the inside, attaching the screen mesh. Here's a second piece of corrugated plastic, which is the horizontal portion of the air duct, which is going to help tee it off. Marking the bottom so I can make my lines. And cutting out the bottom panel. Here, it finally starts to come together. This is the lid, cutting only two of the lines, keeping the back one attached, so I can open and close as needed. This is a bird's eye view with the lid open, so you can see the fan down in the air duct. Just notching out a little piece so the cord to the fan can fit with ease. I secured it into place. Once again, hot glue would have worked much better instead of using silicone. I trimmed down the horizontal piece and then hot glued it all together. Next, we'll be going over pumps and filters and how we keep them out of view when looking into the Pilotarium. To do this, we need to drill some holes into the glass. I put down some tape to get a cleaner cut, mark my center. This hole here will be the input to my canister filter. I have a gallon of water and I took a pin to poke a hole so I can cool the drill bit. I also have a guide made out of plywood. When drilling glass, don't apply any pressure. Let the drill do all the work. Once the hole is started, remove the jig and proceed as before. I also drilled this hole, which will be the top of the waterfall, coming from the export of the canister filter. Another hole for water overflow in the land substrate portion. And a fourth hole for water overflow of the aquatic section. Viewing from the back, here's all four holes. Smooth the holes with wet sandpaper. Added some silicone to the front of the corrugated plastic to help the great stuff bond a little bit better. I try to start with the hardest to reach spots and lowest points to make spray foaming a little bit easier. But overall, it's a super simple process, and I'll be speeding up the video during these parts of the build. Just lining up and marking in where I want my air duct to go. After that, just silicone the back side so I can go ahead and place it onto the back wall. Starting to get an idea of the different types of wood that I'll be using in this build. But right here, I have cork bark, spider wood, ghost wood, and different types of driftwood. Starting to hide the internal air duct, I'll be using cork bark and hot glue to attach it. I'll be using a few different pieces to help camouflage it all together and make it look like all one piece. I added this 90 degree PVC elbow, which will be the top of my smaller waterfall. Then I started to spray foam all around it. When doing more detailed parts of a build, I generally break it off in sections, taking my time rather than rushing through it. While the foam was still wet, I stuck a piece of paper into the PVC and sprayed it down with water. After the foam cured, I started building up with the second layer on where I wanted my water to flow. When adding foam on thick, it's best to do it in layers so it allows the foam to cure correctly. Now we'll start working on the larger left side waterfall that'll be hooked up to my exterior canister filter. For this, I'll be cutting out a few different pieces of insulation board. I would have used thicker board, but this is what I had on hand. Once I had my pieces cut, I went ahead and siliconed in the first piece. I made sure to install it below the lip of the water land divider. After that, I started grate stuffing in the remainder of the insulation board pieces. Here's a little quick tip so your can doesn't cure on you. Just wrap it up in tin foil so you can use it a little bit later. After everything dried, I stood the tank back up and started sketching in how I wanted my water to flow. Then just started cutting it to my liking. There really is no rhyme or reason to how I do this. You can have the best plan, but then it just kind of starts taking its own course. You can also use various different types of wire brushes attached to a drill. I did use a heat gun to tighten the foam a little bit before using dry lock. I like to get a good base of dry lock on the water feature before adding more foam so I can ensure a nice watertight seal. So in other words, I build it up consecutively with using foam, dry lock, foam, and dry lock to make sure that it's a watertight seal, because one pinhole can throw the whole thing off. Adding another coat of dry lock in a different color so I can see where I need to paint next. I have the tank flipped on its back and I'll be foaming over where the corrugated plastic meets the insulation board to tie it all together. There's also dry lock underneath it to ensure an extra watertight seal. This might be overkill, but it's worth it to take the extra time now rather than having to do a repair after the Polydarium is up and running. Now I can start adding more detail to the water feature, feeling confident that it's watertight underneath. Making sure to cut off any of the shiny parts of the spray foam so dry lock or silicone will attach to it. Once again, building up some more detail as I add more to the waterfall. Once I started to like how it was coming together, I then went ahead and started dry locking the whole entire thing. I honestly don't know how many coats of dry lock I used, but if I had to guess, it's probably between 10 and 12. I like having the peace of mind knowing that it won't leak. I do my final coat in dry lock using the darkest color possible. Now we'll start adding texture to the fake rock by using a dry brush method. We'll add a little bit of quickcrete to the dry lock, mix it in so we can get different tones. During this step, you want to get the smallest amount as possible on your brush and pretty much take it right off. Then lightly go over what you've created. As you build up your tones, you'll really start to see the detail come to life. I'll be using a 90 degree, half inch nylon hose barb as the top of my waterfall. That way I can swivel it left and right. Along with this rubber washer. I just silicone around the rubber washer so it would seal to the back of the enclosure. Then added a little extra silicone. Putting the enclosure on its back, I then started adding more great stuff to tie it all in. Inside the hole, I also added 5/8 inside diameter, 3/4 outside diameter hose that I'll be pulling out after the foam cures. I covered the vertical part of the 90 degree elbow with great stuff. Once the great stuff cured, I pulled the hose out of the top of the waterfall. I sketched around the 90 degree elbow covered in great stuff so I can go ahead and make a cut. Making sure not to go too deep so I don't puncture the dry lock behind it. Pulled out the foam where needed. Then test fitted the piece I made. I can have it facing straight down, point the water flow to the right, or to the left, so I can adjust as needed. Then I just dry locked everything in using the method as before. I'll give the dry lock a good 7 to 10 days to go ahead and dry completely before doing a water test, which is fine because it now gives me the opportunity to start working on the rest of the hardscape. So I'll start hot gluing in some ghost wood. After everything was in its place, just started adding more spray foam. To add planters, just spray foam over the top. After it cures, put the tank on its side and start spray foaming again. I like to sketch out, carve, and create a lot of hiding places for what's going in the paludarium. Filling in some gaps that air bubbles created. Also going around a feeding dish so I can have easy access to a feeding station and take it in and out with ease. I'll just stack the fresh dish right on top of this one here. Then just carve away the foam and move on with the rest of the build. Test fitting the top of the air duct with a piece of cork bark that I cut to size. Then trimmed it down a little bit so I can go ahead and adjust for when I add silicone and cocoa fiber. I just wanted a tight, snug fit. Behind this hole is our screen mesh that our 40mm fan will be sucking air through up through the air duct. To help tie it all together, I'm simply just putting silicone anywhere that I see spray foam. When working in tight spots, it helps to use a paintbrush to spread the silicone. Then just take cocoa fiber or whatever substrate you'll be using, press it into the wet silicone, and let it dry. For anywhere else that you want cocoa fiber on your hardscape, just repeat this same process. After you finish a section and it's been about 24 hours, lift the enclosure up, knock off any loose substrate, tilting the enclosure forward and tapping the back of it will help out a lot. Collect what fell off so you can go ahead and use it later. Then use a vacuum to get the rest of it all off. Then repeat the same process on the other sides. scraping off any silicone that got on the top of the rim of the tank, using a variety of different razors and knives to clean up the glass. When detailing or trimming up the dry lock off the glass, I generally make a cut about an eighth of an inch to a quarter inch away from the spray foam. A flat razor scraper also works great for getting splatter marks off the glass. Here's a quick picture of the work done so far. This tube is connected to our 90-degree barbed hosed elbow that'll connect to our canister filter, which will feed the top of our left side waterfall. I just added another rubber washer and some hose clamps to hold it in place, and another 90-degree barbed hose elbow. Attaching the hose that'll connect to the output of the exterior canister filter. I'll be tying in this exterior water heater that comes from the hose attached to the exterior canister filter. I wanted the water to circulate as much as possible. That's why I have the input to the canister filter on one side of the tank and have the export on the other side of the tank, dumping at the top of the waterfall. I'll be using a small pump for the right side waterfall. The hose to the small pump will go to this PVC elbow that we installed earlier in the video. It's been over 10 days since the last coat of dry lock, so we're ready for a water test. I was able to get just over 16 gallons. Everything was running smooth with no leaks for over 72 hours, so I continued on with the build. I gave everything a good spray down, especially on the dry lock, getting a good visual for where I want my fogger to come in at, marking part of the glass lid so I can start drilling some holes. For the top, I had a piece of 1/4 inch glass cut to 34 inches and 5/8 by 13 inches. I usually make my own lids using window frame with a 2-inch gap, putting screen in between. Just making sure I sand down where the swing arms go. But for this build, I found a really cool company that makes 3D printed lids. It has Miss King mounts with plugs if we're not using it, screen, and a cover to control humidity. I went ahead and siliconed the pieces together, although it's not required. If you don't silicone the pieces together, you can always take it apart and use it on a smaller tank. I went ahead and cleaned off the inside lip and the glass with rubbing alcohol, placed the pieces into their designated spot, taped off the glass and the frame, then ran a bead of silicone on the inside lip of the frame where it meets the glass. Put the frame back into its designated place. Then ran another bead of silicone between the frame and the glass. Then used a spoon, applying even pressure to get a nice smooth seal. I did the same process on the other side and pulled the tape off within 10 minutes. I drilled a hole into the glass above the back chamber so I can fit this desk grommet into. I'll have the cord to my mini water pump coming out of this. Added some weights to hold everything in its place and let the silicone cure for 24 hours. I'll be attaching my fogger to these half-inch bulkheads. To keep anything from leaving the enclosure, I just took some screen, cut it to size, went ahead, added some silicone, placed the screen on top of the silicone, and worked it in, trying to get the smoothest finish possible. Once the silicone dried, I went ahead and added the bulkheads for the fogger. Everything came together real nice. I went ahead and took the lid and placed it off to the side. Working on the inside water chamber, I wanted to make the water pass through as strong as possible, so I added some silicone onto a piece of corrugated plastic that I cut out and pressed in a piece of screen. Then added more silicone above for extra strength. Put it into the back side of the chamber over the hole that we cut out earlier. Pressed it into place and waited for it to dry. Place some bio sponge filter in the back chamber, adding in my mini pump, and some more bio sponge filter over the top. Connecting the mini pump hose to the PVC elbow that goes to the small waterfall. Putting in the input hose that goes to the exterior canister filter. Taking the other end of the exterior canister filter hose for the input and feeding it through the hole that I drilled earlier. Putting the 40mm fans down into the air duct. Using a yardstick, applying even pressure, slowly pushing down. Tucking the cord into the slit I cut earlier, and snapping the lid back into place. Installing the cork bark over the lid for extra strength and a nice finished look. Cleaning off where the bulkheads are going to go for the water overflow drain in the land substrate area. With everything prepped and ready, it can now go up on the rack. Adding LECA for my drainage layer. Added some weed barrier to separate my substrate. I'll be putting ABG mix on top of the weed barrier. Now it's time to start putting in some plants. Filled up the pots with some ABG mix. And then just started planting. Made some vines out of rope, silicone, and cocoa fiber. Tangled the vines together, and then just draped it across the Polydarium. I'll be using EcoPlanted as a substrate in the aquatic part of this build. I boiled some driftwood to get the tannins out so it wouldn't tint the water. Filling it up so I can get the aquatic plants in. Now to install the lid and have that all come together. Feeding the plug from the mini water pump through the desk grommet in the hole that we cut earlier. Using a little bit of plumber's putty to fill the gap between the plug and the desk grommet. I was able to get the USB plug through one of the Miss King mounts that attaches to the 40mm fan, and filed down one of the plugs to fit the cords. I also put silicone and cocoa fiber on the cords to make them look like vines. Test fitted the half inch PVC to the bulkheads to make sure it worked for the fogger, spray painted it black, and installed it in its place. Added on an extension that'll connect to the hose that connects to the fogger. Hooking up the fogger. Turning it on so I could dial in and adjust the density. Hooked up the Miss King nozzles. For the lights, I'll be using the Fluval Plant and the Fluval AquaSky, more or less for special effects. They are Bluetooth connected and hook right up to your phone. For the AquaSky, you have a lot more options as far as color adjustments. You can also adjust those colors or make your own. But with both lights, you have 4 slots to save whatever you create. The AquaSky has a few different dynamic effects. Let's go ahead and take a look at one of them. Hooking up the water overflow drain for the land substrate portion, and hooking up the water overflow for the aquatic portion of the Polydarium. I just use the same tubing as before. Here's a quick clip on how my drainage works if the Polydarium were to overflow. I created its own P-trap. With a shutoff valve if ever needed. That dumps right into my sump pump for no maintenance. Time to add our microfauna to make it bioactive. To start, I'll be using springtails. Then some orange isopods. It's good to have a few different cultures going at all times, so you can seed as needed. Adding in some leaf litter and spreading it out. Placing in a few accents, like cork bark and nut pods. And here it is, the 36 by 18 by 36 Polydarium build. enjoyed the video, like and subscribe. I'll be uploading future videos. Thank you for watching.